buddies, what's going on? Welcome to another episode of The Poor Man Road to Glory. As always, we gotta go through the thank yous. Thank you so much for the support on last episode. I'm gonna be talking a lot about last episode. I'm gonna be reviewing player stats and stuff like that. We just finished off yet another FUT Champions run, and I gotta say, I'm just so proud of how we're doing. First of all, I'm gonna give myself some credit here. First of all, how I'm doing as a FIFA player, like, I'm keeping up with some of these FIFA pros and stuff in terms of how I'm doing in FUT Champions. Now again, before I continue on here, I'm going to spoil last episode, and honestly, you really don't want to miss last episode. YouTube's been screwed for the last couple of weeks, so a lot of people just not seeing my videos in their sub boxes, a lot of people getting unsubbed from my channel. I'm getting tweets from people saying, "The hell, I'm not even subbed to your channel anymore when I didn't even unsub." So if you're watching this video, obviously you're subbed to the channel. Obviously, you're watching the video. But if you missed last episode, I'm going to leave it in the description. Go watch it, because from here, I'm going to spoil it, and it's really worthwhile watching. What an insane run we had. So if you're excited for today's episode, because there's going to be a hell of a lot of stuff. I know you guys like squad builders. You know, a lot of the fans of The Poor Man Road to Glory, again, even in the last video, are like, yo, we love the work ethic that you put into this series. We want to see some squad builders, some investing, talking about what you're going to invest in and stuff like that. So we're doing that all today. You may get some gameplay at the end of the episode. You may not, because we have just so much to get through. Today, or at least in this episode, we're going to be collecting yet another FUT Champions reward pack, and oh my god, is it going to be looking good here. So again, at this point, if you haven't watched the last video, it's going to be ruined. We got freaking gold one! We were in the top 30 in all of the Americas. Let me just break that down for you. That's South America, North America, Canada, you know, the US, Mexico, Brazil. We were in the top 30 people in Ultimate Team on Xbox One on our Road to Glory account. And yet people say I'm just a pro pack opener. I'm a pro bronze pack opener, which allows me to build incredible teams now and allows us to do relatively well in the FUT Champions. And I do think, honestly, over time, maybe, just maybe, if I can get my finishing down, if I can not bottle it under pressure like I almost did at the very end of last episode to get ourselves to gold one, just like we did the last FUT Champions run. Last FUT Champions run, our 2 runs ago, we were at 25 wins. We needed 1 win from 6 games to get ourselves to gold one, and I lost 6 straight. Last episode, we needed 4. We had 4 chances to win. Again, we were on 25 wins with 4 games remaining, 4 chances to win, and I lost 2 straight, and I thought it was going to happen again. Then, as you know, you can see what happened in the video, where it went to. But so emotional. This game is just absolutely crazy. So again, anyways, before we continue, smash the like button if you're excited for this episode. Lots of prizes, lots of awesome stuff, lots of squad builder challenges, which I'm going to do in a few seconds as well for you guys. But the first thing I want to talk about is this guy. Now, I stayed committed to Embolo because I love his card. Last episode, and even the last few episodes, we knew that he got injured. He had an ankle injury, and Schalke even tweeted out saying he's going to be out for 1 to 2 months, but he's going to go for, you know, surgery and whatever. We'll see. Well, more news has come out about Breel Embolo, and he's now going to be out for a minimum of 4 to 6 months, which, of course, means that this guy's price now has absolutely shit the bed. And I'm asking you guys. I want to see where you guys' thoughts are on this, because I really don't know what to do. I decided to stay true to him, to stick with him last episode, the last 2 episodes for the FUT Champions, and it really paid off. Like, this is all from FUT Champions gameplay, okay? And FUT Champions qualification. 54 games played. On a card that we paid 107k as an investment that really has gone bust, the first one this year, so I'm not going to complain too much, because everything else we've done has been just magical in the Poor Man Road to Glory. I'm okay to fail a few times, right? This is definitely one of the failures in terms of the purchase price. Everything else is still a success with Embolo. 57 goals, 16 assists. That's just incredible. Again, I'm watching other YouTubers, other streamers, and they're all my friends, so I'm not being critical or talking shit about them, but, like, I'm seeing other YouTubers with legends, like Itani, the pleb, you know, with his Ruud Gullit at striker, and Itani in 50 games will have like 38 goals or something like that. So Embolo on these type of stats is just absolutely incredible. And bear in mind, I'm going to have a look here, because I actually don't know what his price is going today. It's got to be like 30 or 40k at this point, right? Considering he's out for... That's not even that bad. Like, 60 to 70,000 coins where now people know he's going to be out for 6 months? Like, That's not terrible. I'm assuming a striker card, which is this exact card, has also gone up in price, but we still have lost about 40,000 coins on this card, right? That's the average. So my question to you guys is, we do need a fitness team. And again, I don't want to spoil it, but last episode you really do need to watch because we also got a freaking one to, honestly, last episode may be the best Poor Man Road to Glory video I've published on my channel in 3 years that I've been doing the Poor Man Road to Glory. We packed a walkout, an untradeable walkout Ribery as well. So I do now think that because of the investments we've made in Renato Sanchez, in Ousmane Dembele, who now has been upgraded to a 5-star skiller in head-to-head, so a lot of people are thinking in Ultimate Team, he will be upgraded to a 5-star skiller as well. So this guy's price is due to skyrocket very, very soon as well. And again, look at these statistics. This is just a regular. I mean, if you can't afford 100k for Dembele's one-to-watch card, go buy his regular card. What is he, 5 or 10,000 coins? Look at the stats on him, again, from only FUT Champions. 52 games played for a right winger to get 20 goals and 18 assists is just absolutely fantastic. Now, Ribery did do quite a bit worse. Well, even then, not actually that much worse, but I do love Ribery. What an improvement he's been over Coman. I would highly recommend him to absolutely anyone that's thinking of getting Frank Ribery or a left winger in Ultimate Team, and you just can't afford Marco Reus. Ribery is absolutely incredible. Renato Sanchez started to do a little bit better for me later on. He's not a goal scorer by my experience. He's definitely just a box-to-box midfielder that gets that secondary pass that would lead to like a teammate passing it to a forward to score. And that, I mean, you can tell by stats. Again, only used him in the FUT Champions, 41 games, 3 goals, 4 assists. It's not great if you need someone to score goals, but he was an absolute tank in the midfield. So I still think he's a fantastic investment. Even at this point, I think we've made 10 or 20,000 coins on him. So that's great. I think we've made a little bit of 10 or 20,000 coins on Ousmane Dembele. Again, people that watch the Road to Glory, that watch live on stream me using these cards, yes, my streams have artificially and my YouTube videos have artificially raised the price on some of these cards because you guys are seeing how good they are. I don't know how many times I need to say how good they are, but they really are. Outside of that, it doesn't really matter. A lot of these guys I didn't use. As you guys saw in the last episode, I cashed out early on all of my, Premier League players during the FUT Champions because I finished the FUT Champions early for that week. So I cashed out and I made some good money on Smalling and on Butland and all of that stuff. So that's where we're at right now. I wanted to talk to you guys about stats. There's so much to talk about at the start of this episode that I really had to write it all down for you guys. So we talked about, of course, where we went in Gold 1. Again, thank you for the support on this series. It's incredible that a series like this, a grassroots Road to Glory, a series that we've been dedicated to for 3 years on YouTube, is doing so well and like inspiring so many people on Twitter with the hashtag PMRTG to share their Road to Glory stories, to share their bronze pack method. Again, you know what? I probably should just show you guys the screen cap that I tweeted out here. Again, just a few random packs that we were opening, and look at this. Look at that. Like, another, that this guy sold for like 21. Actually, I think I can show you guys, but here you go. Anyhow, there's the proof for you guys in terms of my pack luck on this account. It's just insane. And I think, what did he finally sell for? Let's have a look at our trade list. So again, did the bronze pack method and like just listing up random things, random items. You know, got a Jarvis as well as a card. Yeah, paid for the 400 coin pack. Healing cards sell for crazy. So the one thing I wanted to talk to you guys as well, that's disappointing. That guy just made 400 coins on that card. The one thing I wanted to talk to you guys about is consumables are actually not going up as much as I thought they would. I think we may have to wait a couple more weeks even before we can start selling our fitness cards and our contracts, our bronze contracts and stuff like that consistently, because like I've been listing up endless amounts of fitness cards and stuff like that. And every hour, I would say out of 50 bronze fitness cards. I'm gonna turn this down a little bit. Is it too loud? I don't think the music is too loud. I'm just gonna turn down my actual headphones here. But out of like 50 or even 60 bronze fitness cards, I sell like 2 to 5 an hour. And right now, considering I can sell players, there's again so many squad builders, which we're gonna do, trust me. The new squad builder, the marquee matchups for you guys, if you're watching this video a week later or whatever, these are squad builder challenges that have happened obviously a while ago, but like I just have so many of these players in my club that so many squad builder challenges that come out, I finished for pretty much free. So again, there's Bradley. That's how much he sold for. Absolutely fantastic. So I'll clear out the trade pile. I'm going to list up, well, no, are all these fitness cards already all listed up? Yeah, there you go. So we'll be able to see how much these fitness cards sell for, how many of them sell for. I think they're pretty close to expiring. The rest of these dudes I'll just list up again. They should sell over time. How much time do we have left? 39 minutes. No, there's no way this straight recording is going to be 39 minutes. But we have a lot of packs to open. Now, I think at this point, I'm going to open these packs. Again, been grinding the bronze pack method, as I showed you guys in the trade pile. So we're back up to two rare player packs. And I actually had a bunch more three uncommon gold through the squad builder challenge. Again, open bronze packs. Use those shitty bronze players to get the silver two untradables. Get a bunch of those. Then use those silver untradable players to get the three common gold packs. Open the common gold packs, then use those untradeable common golds to get yourself the two rare players. You know, again, episode 5, I spend an hour and 20 minutes walking you guys through the bronze pack to squad builder challenge upgrade method, okay? I get people still in the comments saying, how do you do this? Like, how does this even work? Episode 5 is where you need to go look at in the Poor Man Road to Glory. It's like a full educational video on the process. So we'll open these three common golds, then we'll open the two rare player packs, and then after that, I'm not really going to get anything that fantastic here, but after that, we're then going to go, okay, so what do I do here? Please don't tell me I have to discard. Well, not that he's going to sell for too much, but do I have to discard him? Ah, that's unfortunate. Liga Nos player, this guy would have sold for 1,000. So yeah, we're going to open these free ones, open the two rare player packs. Can we get a walkout again? I have no idea. Then we're going to do the squad builder challenges. There's some incredible prizes. I'm going to talk to you guys about that, show you guys how I finished the team. And then we'll open those, and then we'll get into maybe a squad builder, and then get into maybe some gameplay. Later on in the episode, we're going to collect all of our gold one rewards. I'm going to show you guys that in a second. God, there's just so much stuff to get through. I'm so excited for this series, man. This series is just the funnest thing ever. It's crazy. Like, I say this over and over again, but my account where I spend endless amounts of FIFA points, I haven't touched in weeks and weeks and weeks. I literally just use that account to open special packs, to do maybe some random squad builder challenges and stuff like that. Because this account is just... Did we just get a Roma player? Let's go, boys. So that's another one for one of these squad builder challenges. Beautiful. So I think I had to buy one of the Roma players. I will sell that Roma player and I'll use my untradeable Roma player for that squad builder challenge. I need to put that in my head here. Let's see if we can get any other players from the current squad builder challenge. Well, there's another couple of players that we could use. I could sell on some of the other Serie A players that I have from the FUT Champions reward packs from last week or 2 weeks ago, I guess, depending if you're watching the series or not. Ryan Bertrand untradeable, so he's not a player I'm going to put through the bronze pack upgrades. Premier League players, even La Liga players, Bundesliga players, I have decided to not put them through the squad builder challenge upgrade to get the two rare players, because these types of players are the ones that really could help you with other squad builder challenges, and I'm going to show you guys that in a second. Also, I wonder if I'm ever going to get myself an inform from these three common gold upgrades. I see so many of you guys on Twitter, again, with the hashtag PMRTG, that get so lucky. Can this one not be untradeable? Ah, all right, I've had to discard two. That's a little unfortunate. All right, come on. Can we get another walkout this week, please? This two rare gold thing at the start of every Poor Man Road to Glory video. Ah, it's so fun to do. Oh my God. Okay, so Casillas, I don't think I have yet. Do I? Please don't tell me I have to discard him. An untradeable Intep. That's a great card. Okay. So again, maybe we'll need to do a squad builder for one of the FUT Champions qualification tournaments. All right, come on. I don't think I'm going to get a walkout, but... you never know with these things. Who's that? Untradeable Gibbs! That's fantastic! I will not put him through a squad builder challenge again unless we need to for the Premier League. He's a very, very good card. And this Sanchez guy, I will put through the squad builder challenge. Absolutely garbage card. All right, so we didn't get another walkout, a Ribery, or anything like that, but hey... One so far out of, what are we? What episode is this anymore? I can't even remember. I think this is episode 14. So one walkout out of 14 episodes isn't the greatest, but it's not that bad considering the type of team and the type of club we have with the amount of coins that we have. So now I think what we're going to do is we're going to go do the squad builder challenges. Let's go do those. So this squad builder challenge in particular, I've given up on the Del Piero one. I think there's still 14 days remaining. God bless this squad builder because it makes us all rich with the Sydney players and stuff like that. This squad builder challenge as well right now is making the bronze pack method very, very good. These players, so which one should I do? Okay, let's review this one first. Every single one of these players I've had in my club. through the bronze pack method, through the squad builder challenge, through all of that stuff. Absolutely incredible. This player right here, I'm going to show you again. He's pack pulled. How would I show you that? So pack pulled, okay? Have a look at this. These players don't even exist on the market, I think, at this point right now. Like, he's 10,000 coins. Now, normally I would just sell him, but I actually think that it's worthwhile to get the rewards. Maybe not this reward specifically, but the FUT Draft reward, that's 15,000 coins. We could get another FUT Draft unlock. And now on this account, we have two FUT Drafts. And I don't know when we're going to do these FUT Drafts because I'm so, like, addicted to the FUT Champions that it's hard to release content. But you know what? You guys let me know in the comments down below. Next episode, instead of me doing another FUT Champions run or showing you guys a FUT Champions run, because honestly, unless I'm on vacation, on this account, I'm going to try and do the FUT Champions every single time. Like, the 40 games, just get them done because the rewards are so amazing. And then apparently there's also monthly rewards, as we've talked about in a few episodes, where it's really going to be worthwhile. But if you guys want next episode to be a FUT Draft, a free FUT Draft run, see how good I am in the FUT Draft, considering I'm pretty decent against, you know, pro players in the FUT Champions, maybe we can win a FUT Draft. Maybe we can get a semi-final or something like that and see what type of rewards we get. That should help out the series as well. So if you want a FUT Draft in the next video, I'm just going to set a like target. This is randomly in the middle of the video, so not many people are going to see this. But if this video right here hits 5,000 likes next episode, we'll do a FUT Draft run among all the other things that we do. Squad builders, you know, some squad builder challenges and stuff like that. But next episode, instead of FUT Champions gameplay again, I'll show you guys a FUT Draft run with one of our free tokens, all right? So again, let me show you guys this here as well. I think this is one of the guys that said 50 million, imagine. But look at that. Is this one of the ones? Yeah, it is. Like, that's 5,000 coins right there. So anyways, all of these guys from packs, absolutely fantastic. I'll take it. Input that one. So that's fantastic. Now, although most of the players I have in here are from packs, one particular squad did cost me about 12,000 coins to complete because I just didn't have all the players from past packs and stuff like that stored in the club. Now, this one, again, pretty much every single player we just had in the club, so I'm not too upset with it. If you check the market, though, some of these players are crazy money. So again, the Bilbao players, the Sociedad players. So a recommendation I would give you guys, and look at this, we get one premium gold player pack from stuff we just randomly had in the club. So worth it. I was considering putting Inaki Williams through the squad builder challenge, but considering he's such a rare pull, and this card on the market is also selling for, I think, like 10,000 coins now, let's just keep him. I'm watching pro FIFA players use Inaki Williams, and they are destroying people. This guy called Jarba, he plays on PlayStation. He literally swears by him. He has the coins, and he's not even upgrading to Gareth Bale because Inaki Williams is so good. So I'm going to keep my untradeable Inaki Williams. We'll trade this one in for a premium gold player pack. So that's done. Again, this one we did literally through just random players we had in the club. So that's all done. We have it all sorted out. Now, what I'm wondering, though, is I think this guy's pack pulled. Or no, we bought him for 500 coins. I had to snipe one player, but we picked up. Now, is this going to drop the rating down? I'm thinking of doing this. That's an untradeable silver, and I'm thinking of doing this because we did pick up, what's his face? Oh, he's untradeable, so he'll show up, like, far. Let's do this. An untradeable Edin Dzeko. Now, does this get us up to what we need? Like, look at that. So right here, this guy was from a pack, right? He's a pack pulled player. So I'm either going to keep him. I think I'm going to keep him. Like, again, it's not really worth, considering we make so much money off the bronze pack method and stuff like that and getting free players. Someone like this, I might as well just keep for yet future squad builder challenges. But Fazio, because he's a Roma player and we sniped him for 500, what is he going for right now? Oh, like he's going for like 1,500? 2,000? Okay, so I am going to toss this one up. We'll toss him up for like 1,700 and he will sell, without a doubt. Let's make sure he doesn't go for less than what we paid, I suppose. There we go. I can't imagine that he will, but there you go. So, again, Squad Builder Challenges gets us yet another player. This is 1,500 coins and one gold player's pack. Okay, so we already have two players' packs as well. Now, this Squad Builder Challenge did cost me 15,000 coins, or about 13,000 coins because of this one. But as you can see right there, we've already made, what, 3,000, 4,000 coins from the coin rewards, and we've gotten some player packs. And from this one, you get an EPL player pack, not to mention the draft token. So yes, this team did cost me a little bit of money. This is an untradeable Walcott. I was humming and hawing about getting rid of him, but he's untradeable. Like, I might as well just get rid of him anyways. So I think we spent our money on a... Where do I check, like, how much I spent? So there you go. We spent 4,000 coins here, and then I think I sniped one of these players, but I think Lingard, I still had to spend 3,800, and then the rest of the players we already had in Fellaini, I had to spend 3,600. So again, this team still did cost me about 11 or 12,000 coins. A lot of players, again, that we just had, you know, pack pulled, untradeable type of thing. Why not use them? You know what I mean? This guy, I managed to use even a bronze player in the team. You needed it for the nationalities because you need a minimum of 7 nationalities. So bronze pack method, squad builder challenge is working for us there. So let's submit the squad. We get an EPL player pack. Now, right now, high rated EPL players and EPL players in general are selling for good money because of that squad builder challenge. So let's see how we do. So this team did cost us 12,000 coins to complete, but we got about 3,000 or 4,000 coins back. So right now this team has cost us, let's say 8,000 or 9,000 coins. So that squad builder challenge cost us 8,000 or 9,000 coins, but we also got a draft token that it has a value of 15,000. So already, through just doing the methods that we do in the Poor Man Road to Glory, we basically did that upgrade, those squad builder challenges for almost free. Now, what is this? So we have a draft token pack, so we get a draft token, an EPL premium player pack with 3 rares, so that's not that great, but a premium gold player pack, which is 3 rares, a just gold pack, and a premium silver pack. So let's open the premium silver pack first, see what we get. Maybe we'll get another Swedish player, or a Korean player that we can sell on, or a Liga NOS, or a MLS. Doesn't look like we're getting any of them, but let's see what we get here. Gonna really have to watch. Oh my god, okay, that's actually a really poor pack. That's okay. Those players will store. All of this stuff will heal any kits that look good. That's actually a pretty cool looking kit. You know what? I think I'm going to use that. Again, with the Canada red and black and white theme, those two kits are going to look good together. So that's nice. I can't wait to hopefully qualify into gold 3 for the FUT Champions month. I think you end up getting a really, really nice reward. So this should sell considering the, let's go. Considering the bronze one sell for 1,500, this one will go for 1,900, maybe 1,800 on bid. Silver fitnesses sell much better than bronze ones, unfortunately, much more commonly. Contract will sell, oh god, that's too much. Sell that for 300. Again, silver contracts, these will sell as well. Let's go, boys. I love this. This is so fun. This is my fate. I love this series so much, man. I'm like a kid on Christmas every single day. Last night, I couldn't sleep because I knew that, like, today is recording day for the Poor Man Road to Glory, or start of the recording day. This episode, even though it's an hour long, an hour and 20 minutes long, or whatever it ends up being, you need to know that these recordings sometimes go across, like, 5 days. You know, again, I could do what a lot of other YouTubers do and just upload like 7 days a week, or do like 14 uploads a week and just give you guys this recording. 12 minutes long, live, boom. But I like to try and compile it and give you guys my podcast style of Poor Man Road to Glory videos, which are like an hour and 20 minutes long. I now have people even getting angry at me that my videos aren't 2 hours long anymore, the way they used to be in like FIFA 15, I believe. So that's actually not bad. There we go. We'll take our draft token. We'll store the manager. We'll sell these for the 200. Do they sell for more? No, they don't. Okay, so again, we'll actually be lucky to sell these for 200 even. Toss this up for 200. They will sell over time though, so can't be too upset with that. So perfect. I don't even remember what we started with coins wise to see where we go up. Gold player pack, and then okay, so we'll go like this. We'll go this route. Gold player pack, premium, and then the Premier League pack. Come on. All right. Who's that? Ooh, okay, so Correa doesn't really sell, unfortunately. Like, he was going for discard the last time I checked him. Castan might sell. He's a high-rated Serie A player, again, thanks to the squad builder challenge. Like, again, 1,000 coins selling for under 1,000. Not going to sell him. We'll keep him in the club. Castan might be going for a good amount of coins. Let's go. Okay. So we'll toss him up for 1,800. That's fantastic. Ciagarini. It's kind of a lower-rated Serie A player, but I'm wondering if he sells again because of the squad builder challenge going on. He might, you know what, for a player like that, I'd rather put through a squad builder challenge. Same with this guy, like, you know, in the championship, he's just, even if he sells for a little bit, I'd rather just keep someone like that. We'll get the 2 rare player packs out of that. Same with this guy, same with this guy, same with this guy. Same with this guy. Again, the squad builder challenge for this La Liga doesn't have left mids. This guy might actually sell, though. Just have a look here. Not really. Well, actually, what's the cheapest price on this guy right now? Oh, 700. Okay, so we'll keep him for sure. Keep him. Unless Fernandez sells for like a lot of coins randomly, we'll probably just keep him as well. 650 coins, definitely not worth keeping. So we'll store this guy. Now, you are tradable and you're in the Liga NOS, although he probably goes for like five. Yeah, exactly. All right, so we'll toss him up for like 600. Better than nothing, though. So not bad. That pack was really, really good. Premium gold player pack. All right. I don't feel like we're going to get any type of walkout or anything like that, but even someone usable, decent, not great. I know you see that and think Liga NOS, higher-rated goalkeeper and stuff, but the Liga NOS players, if they're gold, they don't sell for anything. It's just the silvers and bronzes! Oh my god, dude! Nep is going to honestly cut his dick off. Like, the pack luck on this account is just mental. Milik also sells for a lot because of the squad builder challenge going on right now. Raheem Sterling! Now, he probably would have sold for a hell of a lot more if the Raheem Sterling Squad Builder Challenge was still going on, but, like, come on, man. 17,000 coins right there? This series, dude. The luck. Who cares about my main account if it has bad pack luck? Look at that. 17,000 coins we get for that pack. And you're telling me the Squad Builder Challenges aren't worth it. If you do them smart, man, you make ridiculous money. So I don't have Julio Cesar. I'm going to keep him. Milik, let's he's definitely gonna sell, right? Okay, 1300. So he sells for surprisingly quite a bit less than I thought. I'd get a couple thousand coins out of him. I will not. Bergrana or whatever, let's see if he sells. Bali, that's a good card. You gonna sell, or I'm assuming this is a play. 3600. Oh, this is a guy from one of the squad builder challenges, isn't it? Oh my god, I'm such a tit. Real Sociedad. Oh my lord, I was gonna store him in the club. Alright, he'll probably insta-sell for 3,000, but there you go as well. That pack is like a 21,000 coin pack. Won't sell. Bali will keep. Can't really see this guy selling. Might be worthwhile just to check in case there's some American fanboys out there. Nope, doesn't sell for anything. Alright. This guy again, Liga NOS, we have him untradeable, so I'll list him up happily for about 800. He'll go. Everything else we'll store in the club. Alright, and we haven't even got to the pièce de résistance. A full Premier League pack. Come on, baby. I can't imagine we're going to get anything nuts, but feel free, EA. Who we get? I'll take it. Ooh. I wonder, like, someone like Mustafi. Do we just keep? Nah, probably not. That's a good pack pull as well. So we got Mustafi. Holy crap. Capcom Tom would be jizzing all over the place. Look at that super link, man. Mustafi and Mertesacker. Okay. Let's see how much Mustafi... Oh, my God. And you're telling me this doesn't work. God, people are dumb. You know what? Let people be dumb. Don't believe that this system works, honestly. I'll keep getting rich on the poor man account. All right. Let's do... Wait, what was he selling for again? Okay, I gotta be careful here. So we'll toss him up for 9,500. We'll toss Mertesacker up. And again, Mertesacker sells for good money because of that... the squad builder challenge is going on. So we'll toss him up for like 4,400. He'll sell. Lord Obi Mikel. He's not high rated, so he probably. Really? Ah, Lord Obi Mikel is not going to sell for very much, so we'll keep him. Evans doesn't sell for much. Again, the lower rated you go, I feel like the less likelihood a player is going to sell. And you need a Man U. What was it? A Man U player? And a Liverpool player. Do I have any of them in there? No. So I don't really think any of these guys are going to sell for very much. If they go for under 1,000, not even worth listing. This guy will be under 1,000. I'm pretty sure all of these guys will be under 1,000. Gideon's Lallin, right? Yeah. Shit stats. Such a promising player, but like those stats, so bad. I'm assuming he doesn't sell. Yeah, he doesn't sell for very much. Okay, well that's not bad at all. So I'll store all those players in the club also. And look at the coins just slowly building up. So I think we might even crack over 200,000 coins right now. Once Mustafi sells and all these other dudes sell. Absolutely unbelievable. And you can't even say that people are buying my cards. I'm not even streaming or doing anything right now. I'm doing this like on a side recording right now with some spare time that I have because I wanted to make sure I got those squad builder challenges done. So we'll send him to the club. We'll use him in a squad builder challenge as well. So think of that right now, before we get this week's FUT Champions rewards, which, let me remind you here, let's just ooh and aah at this again. Gold one on a Poor Man Road to Glory account. I still have a win to play as well. It's just, I'm not gonna bother there, because it just doesn't really help me out. It might help me out monthly in the monthly rewards, but one win, I'm done. I'm done with this FUT Champion. Super, super stressful. 26 wins out of, let's say, 40 games played. So proud of that. And look at this, guys. Again, for you guys that don't keep up with this series, we're already at about 200,000 coins once the transfer list sells. 50,000 extra coins and two 100k packs, bros, in this episode. So, honestly, probably, considering how good the pack luck has been on this account, I can't imagine we're going to get anything out of those two 100k packs that we're going to open later on in the episode. But, like, come on, man. Doing so well. And that, so let's say we'll be at 250. Let's say out of those 100k packs, so 250,000 coins with the rewards, maybe by the end of the episode, if those things sell in the packs, and even if we get like the worst pack luck ever, I'll probably still be able to make 50 or 60 or 70,000 coins from those two 100k packs. I'm hoping. So we could be at like, let's say 320,000 coins at the end of this episode with all of this club, with all of these investments, 320,000. We sell him for 60 or 70, that's close to 400,000. We sell him for his 120,000, that's like 520,000. Sell him for his like 140, 150,000. Like, we are already at around six to 700,000 coins built up on this account just from grinding the bronze pack method, the squad builder challenges, and doing really, really, really well in the FUT Champions. Not a dime spent on this game. It's incredible how good the pack luck is on this account. This is my third pack. Again, it's a different day, obviously. It's my third pack. Yeah, it's as if the guys at EA are like, okay, this account Nick spends no money, or this account this dude spends no money. We really want him to spend money on FIFA points. Let's just give him good pack luck in his free packs and stuff like that, so that he thinks his pack luck is amazing, so that he drops 12,000 FIFA points and then spends the money on packs. Unreal. What is he going for? Now, he's a right back. As long as you're not a striker as a Sydney player, they sell for a lot of money.
Holy shit!
Indeed.
Hi, Nick.
Indeed, holy shit.
The other night, you left me completely baffled. Greatest stream I've ever had. Keep up the good work.
Yo, Jimmy.
Holy shit!
What in the hell, man?
Spent 2 hours doing BPM, ended up getting two player packs and got four duplicates. In a rage, opened three packs and packed a Ronaldo on my RTG.
Yo, congrats,
amazing,
man!
I wanted to share the wealth, hope everyone stayed safe during the storm.
Unreal.
Love you, man.
Love you too, dude. Thank you so much. Okay, holy lord, that Nitrous! Deep. Thank you! I love you, dude! Appreciate you, Nitrous. Joe, thank you so much as well. Seriously. And by the way, Sandalen, you're welcome for the raid, my bro. You're very, very welcome. It's the least I can do in my streaming life is help out other smaller streamers. I try to do it every end of every stream to help out. So, God bless. Is anyone else's pack luck this good on the bronze pack method? I have no idea. Is this a joke? Is this actually a joke? About 3,000 coins later, right? Considering we got the other Sydney player, we've opened, 3,000? We've opened like 10 more bronze packs, and we just got another Sydney player. I'm literally printing coins on the Poor Man Road to Glory account. Dude, he's extinct! That's an instantaneous 10,000 coins right there. Yeah, it doesn't work though. It just, no one else do this. Clearly, no one else is doing the bronze pack method because of how much fucking money I'm making. Oh my god. Alright. You know what the beauty would be as well is if this guy sells for a crazy amount of money, because he's Liga NOS too, isn't he? Yeah, whatever. I'll take the 200 coins. I'll take the 200 coins. Unreal. I kind of want to do that type of a dance. Is this happening right now? Is this... Yo, Rubanios, thank you for the sub, dude. Again, we've opened, what, another 10 or 15 packs, and we've gotten another Sydney player? This is mental. This is actually insane. What in the fucking hell? Dude, the pack... Oh my god, 7,000 coin bid. 7,000 coin bid, 8,500. Let's check the. There we go. This is where we'll be able to tell what he's going for. Cheapest on the market. 8,500 is so far what I've seen. So we can toss this card up for 8,000 coins, and he's gonna sell. And I don't even think the other Sydney player is sold just yet. Oh, EA Sports, I love you and the pack luck you give on this account. God bless. All right, so that's our warm-up game done. We are going to go into the FUT Champions. I think we're just going to go into the FUT Champions directly right now. Candy, thank you for the sub, man. I'm not going to show you guys any part of that game other than this, like, quick review of our warm-up game. Dominated my opponent. Just absolutely dominated him. Like, look at that. Goal for Sanchez, goal for Mbolo. Götze, Dembele, both on assists as well. Just insanity how this guy managed to somehow stay in the game. But sometimes that's how FIFA's going to play against you. I feel like last year, a game like this, I would have honestly lost. I lost my mind. I yelled and screamed like a lunatic at the, you know, pixels on the screen here. But we still managed to come out of this with a win. Ribery had a miss too? Oh, look at this bicycle kick. Oh, I honestly thought I was going to score that. Screw his Payet. No one cares. That's probably like one of his few shots he had. This was gorgeous though. Look at that. Look at that play. Out of all the struggles I had, I then managed to put in that beautiful play. God. That's when FIFA feels beautiful, when you score something like that. Oblak with a save. This was good too.
Sorry, but is it fair to be so mad at your opponent if he is not cheesing and he is playing? Fair. Might be lucky, but still.
Yeah.
Love your stream, but that was not fair, mate.
Why is that not fair? I'm allowed to get mad. I didn't get mad at my opponent. I got mad at the game. I can do what I want. Thank you for giving me $4 to tell me what I should and should not do. I appreciate that. I'll take your money. I'll put it in the bank. I'll probably buy myself like a, you know, I don't know, maybe a pumpkin spice latte or something like that. So I appreciate the $4, but I'm allowed to lose my shit. The game felt so horrifyingly broken. I think we already looked at that. Sparkro, thank you for the 10 months, dude. Appreciate you. Of course I'm allowed to get mad. That's not fair. What's not fair about me getting angry at the game mechanics, just not letting me get a goal? Where was it here? Another Oblak save as well. This was kind of stupid. Ah, that was just my bad. I didn't put it in the corner. I fired it right at the keeper. There's so many more chances. And then finally we get the second goal. Just a good play again. Double tap finesse near post. Goes in the net. Thank God. Holy mercy. Okay, so I'm going to go directly into the FUT Champs. If there are any squads that you guys wanted me to look at, I'm going to look at those in a little bit. Black Mamba, thank you for subbing with Amazon Prime. I'll take the extra 4,000 coins with all those Sydney FC players. We've done very, very well. So yeah, I think the FUT Champs rewards you guys are going to get next episode, all right? Because we've just done way too much in today's episode. And I know that I put a lot of content in each episode, but like, I got to kind of be fair to myself as well. Like, it's just, it ends up being a little bit too much when I put a billion incredible things in one episode. We kind of got to split it up a little bit. So here we go. We have one of our free draft tokens from all of the things that we've grinded over the last couple of episodes. Please, 433. Let's go. Now, one of my biggest worries with doing FUT Champions is getting a formation that just I don't like using. I'll take a version of 433. That's going to be close enough to what I want. Can we get... Whoa! Ooh, I think we have to go Del Piero. I mean, we have to go Del Piero. You just have to go Del Piero. I feel like maybe at some point I will get another Messi, hopefully. I don't know how the FUT draft works, because this is honestly the first FUT draft I've done in FIFA 17. You guys know how much I hate the FUT draft, let's be real. So I'm actually going to plow through this. I'm not going to take too much time. Oh my God, give me that Neymar. So, and I'm going to go with just a team I know that can get me wins. So it's probably going to be like a La Liga team for the most part. And then, ooh, I haven't really used Di Maria. Would Di Maria be hard to fit? Oh, he's got 5-star skills. I forgot. Would Di Maria be hard to fit into a team? I'm going to go Di Maria. I'm going to go Di Maria. Let's go central and see what we get out of this. Come on. Oh, God. So it's really going to be like, I think we're going to go with Gabby. Yeah, let's go with Gabby here. Mahanti, thank you for the 9 months, dude. Let's see what we get here. Give me another legend. Oh, ooh. Fernandinho looks great. Now, Bruno with a shadow would be super sick, but Koke is also incredible as an attacking option. He has high work rates as well. You know what? I'm going to go with Koke. I'm going to go with Koke. So Di Maria is going to be slightly off of Kem for the time being, anyways. We could use Di Maria as a super sub as well. Or we just go with Perea. So this could be an interesting little hybrid here. Let's go with Perea. We'll swap him around like that and see if I can get myself a Premier League right back here. If not, we're going with La Liga. Oh my lord. I'm going to have to go with Hector Bellerin. Best right back in the game. I've used Bellerin for about 15, 20 games. I used Walker for about 15, 20 games. Bellerin is better. I don't know what exactly makes Bellerin better, but he is just better. All right, give me a Marcelo. Give me a Marcelo with a shadow. Ew. Oh, damn, I'll take it, baby. What the hell? Dude, it's really hard to see which players you actually select. I'm definitely going to go with Marcelo. Ooh. Oh, that's okay. Thank you. Yo, is that from YouTube? Okay, I'll look.
No, it's not.
It's not from YouTube?
No.
What the hell is that? Okay. I'll do an unboxing. I don't know if I'm going to do it for a recording for YouTube right now, because I am recording! Okay. I have no idea who that's from. Thank you, Steph! Batman, thank you for the 15 months! Maybe I'll open it quickly. I have no idea. It looks like clothing. Alright, so I guess we'll go Mangala here. Hopefully we get a Spaniard on the left. Come on.
That D.
Ooh, Lord.
What's your opinion on Del Piero? Is he worth a million?
I think he is. Yeah. Sparkro, thank you for the $5, dude. I think, oh God, this team's going to get a little bit dumb, but if we get a Hugo Lloris, we're looking actually pretty decent. But then I could go with Varane. I could go with Varane, and then that locks everything out. Oh, God. I'm going to have to go with Varane for the chem. I'm going to have to go with Varane for the chem. Because we got two players off of chem here. I know, I feel bad not using Toby Alderweireld. I'm a big fan of that guy. Okay. So do we go with the super OP Alves? Or do we go with Ter Stegen? All weekend long, I had to hear Net bitch and moan about his opponents having Ter Stegen and him robbing them. But, like, Alves looks good now. He's 6'2" as well. So I think I'm going to go with Alves. I do think I'm going to roll with Alves. Yo, this team though, on 100 chem. Let's see what we get here. Oh my lord. Woo! What up, dude? So we could use Bellerin as a super sub. All right. We could go with Sergio Roberto at right back if I need to. Oh my god. Manolas super sub 100%. A guy scored a banger from long distance with regular Manolas and his 19 shooting. Jigsaw, thank you for the sub, dude. Appreciate you. Don't really care about any of these guys if I'm completely frank with you. I'm not completely Lucy, that's for sure. Just frank. No one got that joke. I should probably just delete my YouTube and Twitch channel. Oh my god, Ronaldo. Sub, gonna be a sub at, gonna be a slut, what, slut? Gonna be a sub for sure. Oh my god, Ronaldo, Neymar, and Del Piero. Fist me, daddy. Please don't, that might hurt. Axel Witsel could be a pretty good sub. You need subs in this game. Oh my god, Cristiano Ronaldo, this is beautiful. What a freaking fun draft. Watch me get knocked out first round as well. Okay, I'm going to go with Silva. Hesse, I'm sorry, dude. We miss you. We miss you and we love you. Komen. Holy crap. Mohamed Salah is a boss, too. I kind of need, like, some more defensive midfield options, though. I don't really need attacking options. Can Nolito be used in the midfield? Yeah, let's go this route. Yeah, I might put Neymar at right wing. I haven't decided yet. I need to try and get myself another, like, La Liga mid then, really. Because outside of that, it's going to be pretty difficult. So we could go with Pedro Leon and just force him into the midfield off of Kem. Maybe. This might end up being a boring La Liga team, but I just don't care. Oh, now, okay. You could go with Gonzo and you'd give me a strong link to Neymar, but like, and didn't they used to play the same team in Brazil? I think they did. Wow, man, Gonzo, Neymar's got you beat, brother, in terms of career path progression. But anyways, Asensio, let's go. This is what I'm thinking of doing right here. This, Neymar can just, Neymar. Di Maria can end up being a super sub. Do something like that. Now, I do not really like Ronaldo as a winger. I love Ronaldo at striker. I think he's the best striker in the game. I do not love Ronaldo on the wing. So, like, I'm also kind of tempted to keep Neymar and Di Maria in the team and then sub on Ronaldo at striker and then put Del Piero into the midfield. That's kind of the route that I'm thinking of going. That's where I kind of want to go. We'll see though. I might hum and haw about it. Okay, Vidal is another good sub at right back to have to just go with a full La Liga team. Oh my. Okay, do we go with the shit CUNT that Zwei hates? Absolutely. People say I look like this guy. I mean, as much as I'd love to take that as a compliment, PK is a much better looking dude than I am. Let's be real. I mean, I think, you know, I've locked up a better looking woman in Steph than Shakira, but don't tell Zwei that either. None of these guys matter, so they'll get taken out. So I'm thinking at this point we do this. And you know what? Now I can use Bellerin, so I don't even have to worry about this Vidal. Sergio Roberto will keep as a super sub. Manolas will keep as a super sub as well, so maybe we'll get rid of Pedro Leon. What are we thinking about just rolling with this team? Perea's good to keep, and then this guy, I think I'm going to put Di Maria in as a super sub. We can use Di Maria in the midfield. Does Di Maria still have high work rates? High medium work rates. What a card. Axel Witsel kind of feels like a really good card to keep. I've got a decent amount of wingers, huh? Nolito, I might take you out, brother. There we go. I think that's the route that I'm going to go with. Neymar's on 6 chem. Are there Brazilian managers or La Liga managers this year? Yeah, I think that's the route. Again, not that I'm really going to use Mangala either, so maybe have Nolito. Maybe that's the best option. There you go. That's a good amount of substitutes. In case my goalkeeper gets red carded. I know that's highly unlikely, but like it's still possible. Having a goalkeeper in there might be important. Now we could use Di Maria at center mid. We could go here. Not that that's going to change anything, but like Asensio at halftime could get removed for Di Maria. We could then get maybe a more defensive option if we need it. Like again, this is the team. This is the team right here. Let's get a manager and see what we finish up with. I can't believe we've got a strike force of Del Piero, Ronaldo, and Neymar. Oh, there we go. Liga Santander, baby. So that means Neymar goes up, right? Let me see here. Yeah, he goes up to 7 chem. So let's go with this. Perfect, boys. Wait, what? Why does Neymar not have 7 chem? Hello? That's still a sick team. For my first ever FUT drop, I think that's awesome. Again, people in the comments are just going to moan endlessly that I don't have... Oh, God. Don't bottle this, Nick, that I don't have, a more original team. But that's just delicious. I don't know if I should be playing against this guy. He's got Spanish name and everything all over the place. So I'm hoping the connection is okay. Not to mention, whether I'm playing South American or someone, they're insane at the game. And I really should try and pick and choose my opponents here. In terms of, like, maybe not my opponents. I have no idea. But,
Del Piero.
Dude, the lag. Oh my god, Marcella. Like, fuck's sakes. Are you serious? Green connection and I'm still dealing with this trash?
The attacking third. Neymar.
Please! Fuck! Please!
To post.
Yes! Suck me hard, bro! Get out of here! Jesus, the lag is so bad! Green connection! I should have known, though. Seeing this guy's entire team all in Spanish, green connection or not, I should have known that it was going to be this lag disaster. Thank you! This is insanity, dude. I hope I just cut out everything other than the goal I scored, because the FUT draft turns me into Satan 2018. This is, honestly, it feels, other than generating coins from this, this feels like the worst game mode in FIFA. It just does. It's idiotic, man. The lag you got to deal with, which maybe is just my opponent, you know, could just be that.
Time is concerned, it's 4.
Oh my god. But like, it's just impossible. I've been stuck in my own end for pretty much the entire game off of the sheer fact that I just can't seem to make passes. I mean, I'm gonna do a bit of both, honestly. Here we go. Let's go, boys! That's how you gotta do it! take my time, slow it down, lock up the first win. That's first round. I'm tempted to message this guy first of all and ask him, where does he live? Does this guy live in Australia? Like, why is his connection so bad? Second of all, I want to see where this guy is. Like, if this guy's in round one, he's an insanely good FIFA player, man, for being in round one. So I think I just got unlucky there, playing someone that good with that terrible of a connection. Woo! Anyways, so far, we're doing okay with this free draft token. At least we're in round two. Not really much to show you guys. Ronaldo getting man of the match. So I switched a few things around. That's the team where it all, I guess, ended up 80th minute onwards. But let's keep plowing on. Like EA plows me in my butthole. I don't understand how it's so hard to find games that are clean connections. Oh my god, this five at the back penis. Oh god.
And it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession.
I just got shoved off the ball before I could get a shot off. I just got shoved off the fucking ball.
Good position here. Wonderful chance. Saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch. Well, I think they're trying to outdo each other, these two goalkeepers, with the saves that they're making. Neither will be beaten.
What the fuck? What?
PK! Corner count rising.
This is fucked up.
Well, here we can see the corner count so far.
Let's go! Dude, I could show you guys the last 20 minutes. I probably shouldn't, because all it's been has been me moaning and bitching and yelling and screaming. How do people play the FUD draft? How do people play the FUD draft? This is the worst game mode in FIFA. This is 1,000% the worst game mode in FIFA.
Good position. They've worked this attack very well. Well, it's called offside.
Offside, let's go, boys. Pump this up the field. I'm going to give this to someone that's, you know what, dude? Consider it. I hate to do this. This makes me a dickhead. I get it. But, like, honestly, you just got it, man. Played into the corner. Just give it. Yeah, there we go. There we go. He just fucking. This game is so broken. Please let this be the end of the game, man. Holy God, have mercy. All right, well, the FUD draft. Oh, the pleasure of the FUD draft. Anyways, well, we're going into round three. Oh, yeah, I'm definitely going to need some Advil after all of this. Oh, my good Lord. Who finds this fun? Holy fuck, this game. It's offside, too. Won't even matter, dude.
Intervention like that, get back on the ball when they're defending so much. Good link up.
What the fuck is Ronaldo doing?
Well, that's not so much an interception as a poor pass.
No, Marcelo, just get back, bro, please.
Alex Del Piero here. Good forward play from them. Okay. How frustrating is this for the other team trying to get them?
Yes! Let's go! Jesus! This is worse than FUD Champions, brothers! I swear to God! These guys just riding on Park the Bus. And then, like, just luck and flukes and lag. Wow. God bless any of you guys that play the FUD draft a lot. You must have the patience of a saint. The patience of Mother Teresa, man. I can't. I'm going on Park the Bus, dude. Let's see. Both of us on Park the Bus. What happens now, bro? You and your five in the back. I'm sure he'll instantly score, too, due to some garbage. Yep. It's coming, isn't it?
Got a bit of menace to it. Well, this is how this team can play. Sustained.
Here we go. Yeah. Park the bus, dude. Park it. Keep parking the bus, dude. Oh, my Lord. Who is that? This is the scariest thing I've ever seen. Honestly, this couldn't be at a worse time. I love you to death. I do. Honestly, I do. Okay, Bub, please. For the love of God, you're like your mother. Yeah, please! Oh, God! Who is this skeleton that's trying to sabotage the game? Oh! Okay, okay. This is great play, by the way. Oh my god, the play! Ethan, this is for you, buddy. This is for you! Oh, you're not here. Oh, you're still there. Ethan, I thought I almost scored. Why is it still the 78th minute, man? Oh, you're back. Cool. That's cool.
It's gonna go right to the wire here with this one goal lead.
No, damn.
Well, they've upped their game. There's no question about that. Just listen to them.
Yeah, they've been brilliant. But it's been a close game, and you wouldn't put it past the visitors to.
Is Ronaldo getting to this? Nope. Look at that panic pass up the gut. Panic pass twice! Panic pass twice up the gut, Ethan. Twice. And he gets away with it. Can you believe that? Where did you go?
To restart with a throw.
Can you believe that, Ethan? This guy, man. No. Ethan, please, I beg. Please, please. Be my good luck charm, Ethan. Oh my god. Yes. That's a foul. This game is so rigged, Ethan. This game is so rigged. No, JL Gamers, thank you. Okay. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, Ethan, let's go. I got this. That's fine. Okay, no worries. He'll, again, panic pass up the gut. Won't do anything. Panic pass up the gut. Will do absolutely nothing. Deflect the ball, goes right back to him. Del Piero just shimmies away! I can't deal with this game, Ethan. I can't. Your dad's gonna have a... That's a goal. Ethan just ran away. The second my opponent scored, he ran away. I've got full stamina. Neymar has no stamina. Look at this. Look at this fucking garbage. Look at this garbage. The keeper literally just doesn't read it.
Longer to go, but still time for a decisive goal. Which team's
going to
get it, though?
Dude, please, game man.
Between the two of them.
No, Ronaldo, fuck!
Neymar. And is this the moment for them?
Please! Neymar. Yes! Let's go! Let's go! Oh my god! Man's played 80 games of FUT Champions. Never has I ever raged this much at a game of FIFA. Unbelievable trash that you have to deal with. Yeah. Put your controller down, dude. Put it down. Put it down. What are you gonna score? 120th minute. He's gonna score 120th minute goal. Nah. You're not, bro. See, that's the thing here. That's the thing. You want to be a scumbag? Five in the back. Park the bus, dude. Here you go. Here, park the bus. I can be a scumbag too, dude. I can be some of the best. Some of the best scumbags I can be. Woo! God help me. We still have a final to play, dudes, in this draft. Pray for me, baby Jesus. Holy good God. If this guy's as good as Marshall, I'm gonna cry. Should I even be upset here? All right, I'm gonna try and be the new Nick 2018 for this draft final. No rage. Even if I lose this final, I'm hopefully going to get some good rewards no matter what, right? So we've already done the Poor Man Road to Glory a service in getting us to a final. The rewards should be good.
And today, it's just the one striker in the side.
God, it's just such a poor...
And there's worry now about Cristiano Ronaldo.
Ah! Cristiano! Let's go! 3 minutes in, Cristiano uses his strength. Okay, no, remember, you're not a dick, Nick. You don't look at replays, you don't dab, you don't shush people. You're not a scumbag, you're just a classy FIFA player, right? Is that a foul? Is that a pen? Holy shit, that's not even a pen! That's not even a pen! Oh! It doesn't matter! How was that not a pen? Oh my god, man. Okay, did he get any of the ball there? Cristiano with a little bit of LTRT work? It didn't even take a touch. Oh! What? Okay. Think he beat his back line? Nope, he still has another 700 people there.
his teammate through.
Holy God, that last ditch tackle though. That last ditch tackle. Please, Cristiano! Yes! Let's go, boys. I know I score, you know, I conceded a freaking, you know, stupid cross from Pogba, but that is a play and a half. Again, a little bit of LTRT work. Ronaldo opens his body up, tucks it in. Let's go, dudes. 3-1. Oh, my God. What a difference this game is versus the last game, though, that we played. At least, I thought, it feels like this guy's on defensive as well. Look at that. One shot, one goal.
I challenge that to regain possession.
Okay. The cheese, though.
Try and get the ball back now.
Ho! Let's go, boys! Del Piero showing the power! Oh, so what I did there, if it shows it in the replay, the second I got in front of, I think it was Smalling, I tapped LT to shield, it's not even going to show us the replay, to basically bully Smalling off the ball, or use the basically the body Smalling off the ball, and then it's just an RBA to Ronaldo. That's got to be it. That's got to be it, boys. Ronaldo with 4 goals? I think we've locked it up. Oh my God, what the hell? No! No way! Again, little bit of LT, and then the second the player runs behind him, you hold LT RT so he faces up. Oh, that's almost a cheesy goal, though. I'll take it. I'll take it. 5-1. Done and dusted, boys.
4 extra minutes to play here of added time.
Oh, beautiful. Come on. Can we get one more? Can we get one more? Oh, Sensio, the delay! Oh my God, dude. Yo, why am I even stressed? It's all good, baby. I really wanted one more, though. I really want one more. I want one more. Give me 6. Okay. Give me 6, boys. Give me 6. Oh, God. All right, that's fine. I'm okay with it. 5-1. Absolutely unbelievable. What a way to end off this episode of the Poor Man Road to Glory. Again, I always say this, but if you make it to the tail end, an hour plus into the video, smash the like button. You're now at least rewarded with some incredible, hopefully, rewards. Let's see what we actually get out of this. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. We're just going to skip this. No one cares. Ronaldo with a 10.0 from left wing. 5 goals. Oh, my God, man. What an absolute, utterly astonishing performance. So, that's fantastic. I mean, that could just, yeah, I can't be any happier than that. All right. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Now, I've seen a few people win the FUT draft and get insane rewards. I'm talking 45,000 coins, all of that stuff. Now, based off of the luck on the Poor Man Road to Glory account, I would expect that we get something like that. However, I've watched quite a few streamers get just the worst draft rewards from winning. So, let's see where we're at here. We conceded 2 goals and scored 7, 8, 9, 10 goals. So, that's not bad. Come on. Come on. It's going to be crap. It just is. Yo, that's not so bad, is it? Rare player pack. Did I just get a 50k pack for winning the FUT draft? Oh my God. That's not bad. It is a 50k pack. All right, 50k packs are usually trash, but that's okay. Let's get the 5k pack first. Okay, all right, nobody cares. Unless there's something sellable, maybe a gold Korean. Okay, all right, that's awful. We'll keep those guys though. All right, we'll keep those guys. Zedzerik, we'll toss him on the trade pile. These I'm just going to toss on the trade pile for now, and I'll sell them later. I don't want to bore you guys. I know everybody at the end of the video just wants to see this freaking 100k pack. I lied, 50k pack, come on. Is it going to be a walkout? Or is it going to be like Mankio as our best player? 77 rated. Come on, baby! Oh. Wow, that is just the worst thing ever. Oh my God. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. Icardi doesn't sell for anything. Fernandez doesn't sell for anything. Seriously, can anyone do a calculation, even if you want to do it in the comments? But like, we just got a 50k pack. Did we just lose coins? I think that's exactly what happened. So, on that bombshell, as Jeremy Clarkson would say, we'll catch you on the flip side. Jeremy, how is that so hard to get out? Peace!